Dear President of the General Assembly, President of the Economic and Social Council, Excellencies and distinguished guests, this is Myesha Maliha binte Mamun, a final year medical student from Bangladesh, working as an advocate for sexual and reproductive health and rights in International Federation for Medical Students Association. And I am incredibly honored to be a part of this joint thematic event of the General Assembly and the ECOSOC. I believe youths are the future, and if we want to work for a better future, then the first step would be to involve the youths in the process of decision making. I do not believe in just pointing out the problems, but I also believe in finding out the solutions to those problems. Hence, today I'm speaking on behalf of all those youths of the 46 least developed countries and the marginalized groups. I'll be their voice for today. The least developed countries have experienced some positive developments, yet new challenges remains. And with new risks and uncertainties threatening in development gains, LDCs as a whole has a weak capacity to cope with shock and stresses, both at the micro and macro level. Addressing the structural drivers of economic and environmental vulnerability, including natural hazards, lack of economic diversification, in particular, are a high reliance on primary goods production and export, a narrow fiscal base, and weak institutions. The cascading effect of COVID-19 pandemic have exacerbated pre-existing challenges facing young people in LDCs. It has also negatively impacted the livelihoods and human rights of LDCs youth, such as destroying their jobs and disrupting their education. For example, students transition to distant learning, but only 20% of LDC's youth were able to access digital platforms, while over 70% of students in high-income countries were able to. The digital divide continues to threaten LDC success. In many LDCs, there are also considerable challenges related to demographic trends. About 60% of the population in LDC is currently under the age of 25, and the number of young people in LDCs will increase by more than 60% in the next 40 years. The young people in the least developed countries are limited in resources, but are not limited in their willingness to participate in solving issues. Empowering young people in LDCs is crucial to the success of the next program of action. Young people can be a driver for economic growth and social progress if they enjoy health, education, and employment. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development calls for a transformation of all economies, rich and poor alike, to move the world's sustainable development pathways. But to date, SDGs have been seriously underfunded. While the flow of finance is dwindling, the need for it is getting high. The annual financing gap to achieve the SDGs by 2030 currently sits at USD 2.5 trillion. Financial providers have a particular role to play and a responsibility to support the poorest countries to make use of these diverse instruments in ways that are responsible to minimize risk and secure maximum development benefits for low-income vulnerable countries. Public initiatives and public finance need to launch and pilot innovative financing initiatives. It needs to be ensured that suitable financial products, savings, credits, insurance, payments, and remittances are available to individuals. Also, digital finance alone could benefit billions of people by spurring inclusive growth that would add $3.7 trillion to the GDP of emerging economies within a decade, according to a report by McKinsey Global Institute. Therefore, I would like to take this opportunity to call for action from the esteemed guests present here today to empower the youth of LDCs to a sustainable financial budget, which will help to narrow the gap between the developing and the developed countries. Thank you so much.